All right, let's see what's in the rear end. All right. All this lube out, so when I start cleaning, it's not splashing up on my clean surface. Well, it's a positive unit. See the clutch is here. I'll get a marker and we'll count the teeth. The lube in this rear end is pretty fresh, so it's been worked on not too long ago. All right, we start right here. 76 PG11. Hopefully I can keep track. So we got 41 teeth on the ring gear. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 41 divided by 12. Well, it's a GM posi unit. And this rear end may have originally come with 373 gears, but it's got 342s in it now. And actually, I prefer the 342. So it's all good. Brake line goes here, so this bolt is longer than the rest. Before I tighten those up, I'm going to get my posi in it, Tay. I'm not going to tighten these too tight. I'm going to let the Permatex set up. Probably tighten them up tomorrow, since it's pretty cool. I'll give it 24 hours. All right, I'll let that sit for 24 hours. I'll tighten her down, and I'll tighten up the bearing cap preload studs. All right, time to torque the load bolts. So go ahead and run them in. And make contact. All right. All right. And 5 foot-pounds, so that's 60 inch pounds. Can't see with or without my glasses. There. Double check my torque. Tighten the locking nuts to jam nuts to 10 foot-pounds. That's 120 inch-pounds. Time to remove the drive shaft. Ugh. maybe. Good God, that's tight. Yeah, we'll try a ratchet. Oh, jeez. In there. Got that. Yeah, it's a balancing weight right in the way. I hope I don't round off the bolt head. Bad. No, God. Oh, thank goodness. Yeah, that was a knuckle buster for sure. I knew I was gonna lose about half the skin on my hand. Oh. All right, phew. Well, that's it. Look at that. Look at that little wimpy thing. Two of those and three torque converter bolts is all that connects your 500 horsepower Pontiac 455 to the tires. It's just amazing that this stuff doesn't fail, and it almost never does. Gotta be careful here. I don't want to lose my caps. Well, there we go. All right, so take some duct tape. Everything in place. Okay. Move around to the transmission side. Well, hopefully I don't lose a bunch of transmission fluid. Okay. Most excellent. Most excellent. Plugged up. Dirt and getting in there and keeping it from leaking any fluid. Thank you. So, get ready to hang the anti-sway bar. Bracket goes here. I got this bushing. And I'm going to have to put a little bit of lube in there. You know, the kit didn't come with washers, and you know, the holes are so big in this bracket that I thought the nuts would just pull through. Well, it's looking pretty good. Big old sway bar. Should keep the old car from leaning over. I still have to tighten everything up and torque the bottom spring plates. All right, time to torque the U-bolts. I'm gonna torque them to 55 foot-pounds. Torqued. I know the lighting's not the best. All right, we use a 3-inch square drive. Oh, good grief. Gonna have to use a breaker bar. You know, I'm gonna be glad when I get out from underneath this car. We're good. Oh. Let's see if that's enough to use the ratchet. Now, hope you can see this, using Redline 7590, and it's for use with limited slip differentials. I guess it'll take about 2 quarts. Keep it nice and neat. Right, it took just a little bit over 2 quarts. Probably maybe another third of a quart. I'm going to install the new wheel cylinders. I have the rest of the brake parts coming. Changing out your wheel cylinders, make sure you keep the bolts. I soaked mine in purple cleaner for a couple days and took a wire brush to them and put a little black paint on them. And there's little bolts, so you don't want to over tighten them and break them off. Run over the next side, put that one on too. All right, put a little paint on the axle. Looks better. All righty. This one started because it'd be hard to get to otherwise. Well, made a little more progress with the Trans Am. Next thing, we'll get the brakes on it and get the drums on and put the wheels on the car, which will be novel since they haven't been on the car in 2 years. Still a lot to do, but, just keep hitting it. Thank you for watching. And I hope you come back next time and we'll make a little more progress.